Going on 101, San Antonio's greatest hits. Tell everybody your name.
Dani De Waal.
Dani De Waal from?
From Once the Musical.
Once the Musical. That's where she was born. Once the Musical.
It's been part of me all my life.
All your life? Really?
No, I was born in Germany.
What a wonderful, wonderful show.
Thank you.
Thank you. You had me in tears at the end of the show. You had quite a few other people because you caught us with one simple word. I'm not going to tell you what the word is.
Okay.
But you'll know the word. But I want to ask you, if I say the word once, what does it mean to you, Dani?
It means a kind of chance meeting. It means a once in a lifetime happening. It means, you know, a fleeting moment in the spinning universe, you know, and that changes myself and people. You know.
I've heard it said that life is a matter of inches and of seconds. And there are certain things that it's like when that brass ring comes around. You can grab it and you can go for the ride of a lifetime.
Mm-hmm.
Or you can wish and hope and go, well, woulda, coulda, shoulda. And you go, I shoulda, until you should all over yourself.
Yeah, right.
There's some language in this show.
Oh, yeah.
But it's not, you know, it's part of that adult thing of the young adults, as far as an audience goes, what do you think the ideal audience is for once?
Oh,
it seems like to be aimed like, it's almost like a hipster kind of thing.
I think it's certainly got that vibe. I think like age-wise, I think it reaches, it spans, you know, because apart from very small children, like you say, because of language, but I think early on in their lives can kind of go, look to the future in their lives and be like, you know, what do I want to aim for and stuff like that. And people later in their lives might look back and think on people that have been through their lives or opportunities they've missed or opportunities they've gone for. And I think it's got a really reflective quality. And I think that kind of spans across any kind of age of person. And then, you know, style of person. Like you say, you need someone who's a bit kind of down to earth and is okay with a few real life swear words and stuff like that.
Well,
so. It
is real life. And yeah. The show's about real life and real love. And it will tug at your heartstrings. And now that I've finally seen it, I can see why 8 Tony Awards for the music and your performances. You especially, young lady, as the Czechoslovakian. What is your character's name?
Girl.
Girl.
Yeah.
Now, I know it's hard to remember. Girl. Why girl? Why guy? Why so simple?
You know, I think it's the same vein of why once, because it's not, doesn't need to be specific. It's kind of meant to be this everyman story, anytime, any place, could be anyone. And there's really archetypal characters, like you have the bank manager, he doesn't have a name. There are these kind of archetypes that allow the audience, it kind of allows the freedom, I think, to maybe put yourself on it or just be a bit more general about that's not what's important here. It's not that it's Sally and Ben, you know, it's that it's any girl and any guy. And they
what girl does with guy, though, is guy is floundering. He's got problems. He's not a good place. You realize his passion is music.
Mm-hmm.
And your character rescues him. You're his rock. You're his angel.
Mm.
You're his gold. You know how to polish his silver spoon.
Yeah.
And quite often, people do that in life. They'll find somebody else and help polish their silver spoon, and they'll realize their passion, and then they'll go on somewhere else.
Yeah.
I'm not going to say whether or not her character ends up with Guy or not. You're going to have to come and see the show. But you are an angel, really, and you have the voice of an angel too.
Oh, thank you.
Where did you realize that? How long have you been acting?
Pretty much my whole life. You know, I did it when I was very young, as kind of most 6-year-olds do, doing their ballet class.
And
there's a little
girl in the show that plays your daughter too. How sweet is that?
I know, so cute. She's so sweet. Bless her. She travels with her auntie, she's gorgeous. So but I've done it all my life, really, and then did through school and then went and studied and then started working, and that's where I'm at now. So
could you share with our listeners the main lyrics of the song Falling Slowly?
Mm-hmm. Take this sinking boat and point it home, we've still got time.
Take this sinking boat and point it home.
beautiful. Yeah. I'm crying just thinking about it right
I know,
now.
Right?
Because of what it means. If you haven't seen the movie, did you see the movie before
you ever did
the show?
Yeah.
And the people behind the movie, what is their story? Were they lovers? Were they?
They did at some point have a relationship. They were. It's not like their story, but they are. She, you know, Margareta Glover is from the Czech Republic, and obviously Glenn Hansard is Irish. But no, it was a fictional story. But there was something very. I had that same feeling when I saw the movie. I was like, is this real life? Is it a documentary? What is it? And it was also because that kind of low budget feel. You know, I was very intrigued by it. So.
And look at the careers of Taylor Swift, of Adele. Mm. Of Sam Smith. Mm. They all have broken relationships, broken hearts.
Right, oh yeah.
And even Harvey Fierstein said, I could do two things. I could commit suicide or I could write about it. And he wrote about it. And look what it got him.
Yeah.
It got him Tony Awards. It got Taylor hit songs, Adele hit songs. Sam's the hottest thing around right now.
Yeah.
So take your passion, take the losses,
yeah,
and turn them into gold. The choreography, the movement, the dance, the set, so beautiful, so beautiful. Now Xander told me to ask you about, you've only been, how many times have you done this show?
Oh gosh, we're well over the 500 mark.
Yeah. And you've only not done, what, 8 performances?
Oh yeah, less than that. Yeah, I think I missed 2 shows to go see my sister's an actor as well, and I went to go see her shows, and then I think I've had 2 sick days.
Oh yeah, acting family.
Yeah, well, only her, not my parents. But.
Yeah. How about movies and stuff like that? What's?
I mean,
do you
see
Past Once right now?
Yeah, it's hard to because you just don't know. I would love to do telly and film. You know, I'm kind of open to it, to anything. I've definitely mainly done theatre so far, but. You know.
And the Czechoslovakian accent. Wow. Your character is so adorable. She reminds me of several women I know.
Oh, yeah?
That are so precious. Is this role always been done like that, or did you personalize it yourself?
You know, we were given a lot of freedom to kind of find it for ourselves because I saw the original Broadway company, and there was no way we could just try and recreate what they did because it was so individual. So, I don't know. I think my girls maybe got a little bit more... I read her and I just saw her as so positive that although she's got, there's this whole like, you know, I'm Czech, I'm serious. That's complete tongue in cheek, you know, it's, and she's so sharp and she kind of, you know, finds whatever. So I had what jumped off at the page of me was that kind of energy and yeah, like she radiates kind of a joy and she brings that out of people. So I don't know if that's maybe more than other times, but we've definitely been given the freedom to do what we want to do with it.
Something else that's really cool is when you come into the theater, you get up on stage and get your drink there. The party's on the stage.
Yeah.
And then the folk music is so wonderful.
Yeah.
Golly. Yeah. Is it mainly Czech folk music or
it's about
Czech
an even
and Irish?
Czech and Irish, yeah, it's about an even split. And you know, if we're doing a week-long performance run somewhere, it's different every night because they're on about 30 odd songs,
okay.
A pool of, so you literally, the music captain goes, we're doing this tonight, and it goes on the piano. I don't know if you saw that set list, you know, that handwritten one. That's literally what happened. People come on stage and they're like, oh cool, we're doing these, you know. So it's got a very kind of thrown together feel, which is perfect for, it's meant to be a hootenanny in an Irish pub, everyone just kind of joining in. So,
without giving away too much, the word you say to the piano, is that really a tradition? Is that something the authors came up with? It just sounds like it's rooted in reality.
I don't know. I don't know that it is. I think it's just her. Maybe she did it with her dad, you know, like
yeah.
They just said hello to the instruments before it, or you know, before it happened. But
beautiful.
Yeah.
Anything else you want us to know about this show?
I mean, like you say, I would definitely say come early because some people don't realize there's this pre-show and they kind of come on the dot.
Yeah, people are sitting back of us and they're like, what are they doing up there on the stage?
Yeah.
It looks like they're drinking alcohol. Yes, they are.
Yeah, so get up there. So yeah, I would definitely say come about 15, 20 minutes early to enjoy that. But other than that, I'd say come with no expectations and just enjoy the ride and yeah.
It's probably been said before, you have to see once, twice. At least twice, especially with
Thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you. Hi, this is Dani De Waal from Once. We're at the Majestic from now through Sunday. Please come see us.
And go ahead and say on Kona 101.1.
On Kona 101.1.
San Antonio's greatest hits.
San Antonio's greatest hits.
Mecca like a high, mecca high, mecca ho.
Mecca, mecca high, mecca high, mecca ho.
You will too. Come and see Once twice, at least twice, at the Majestic. MajesticEmpire.com and Kona101.1.com. Unless you made it a plan, have a great day. Love you, mean it. We're done.
You've got an awesome voice. I'd love to hear you on the radio.
You're just saying that because yeah. It's a truth.